Okay, now what I'd like to do is update our shopping list app to use all of these techniques we've just learned with templates. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to get rid of this code that we've been playing around with. Get rid of this n equals n. We don't need that anymore. Then we're going to go to our shopping list and get rid of this stuff. We don't need this anymore. Okay, let's go back to our browser and make sure everything's okay. When we reload this, we see our basic shopping list. Type in a food, and it appears in the URL. We can type in a different food, milk, and it updates that parameter in our URL. Now, let's go ahead and add in the functionality that we had before with the hidden input elements and actually showing the list of foods that we had added so far. Okay, now, first thing we do is we can get rid of all of this, well, most of this stuff. Let's uncomment it for now. Okay, so we don't need any of this HTML junk anymore. This stuff was nasty, so let's get rid of all of that. And we don't need any of this stuff. And this line can just go there. Okay, so we're just going to get our food, get all, get parameters food out of the URL, store them in items, and then we're going to pass items into our template. Now, the variable names don't always have to match when you're passing things into the template, but I find very often they do. Generally makes your life a little easier, because then when you're thinking about, you know, you're often working in your template and in your handler, it's handy to just call things the same thing, so you know, you don't have to do that translation in your head. Now, we had all this HTML up here. We're not going to use this anymore, so let's just go ahead and get rid of it. And let's go ahead and update our shopping list template. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is add in the hidden input elements. So if items for item in items, let's add our hidden input. Input type equals hidden, name equals food, value equals item. Notice we can substitute our variable right in the middle of this HTML here, because in the template, the HTML is not special. It's just a string, and we can substitute anywhere into the string that we want. Let's close up our loop. Okay, let's make sure this part worked first. Recall, if this part works, we should see things appearing in the URL. It's always good to test as you go. In case you make a mistake, you don't, you know, have that mistake for too long. Okay, milk, and now if I add eggs, I see eggs and milk in the URL. Let's add some more food. You can see things are starting to accumulate in the URL, which means, if we look at the source, that our template is actually working, and we're adding all these hidden inputs. Notice the white space is all messed up. That's not a big deal. It's basically because our template includes white space, and it's getting put in here literally. But HTML doesn't care about extra white space. All is well here so far. Back to our template. Let's add that shopping list to the bottom. So again, only if we have items. If items. We're going to say, we're going to add a couple blank lines. This is not the best way to add blank lines, but it works for us. Okay, we do our shopping list, and it's going to be an, let's say, unordered list. Now, for each item in items, list that item. Close our unordered list and our if statement. And let's indent everything. And let's fix our indenting. Okay, and let's see if this works. Close the source, reload this page. And there, behold, is our shopping list. Let's add some more items. Cheese. It appears on our list. It appears in our URL. And if we view the source of this page, we can see our hidden inputs here. And we can see our shopping list down here. And if I were to modify this URL, we can see that everything disappears. Likewise, if we delete it here, everything goes away. Okay, very cool. Now, looking at our code, this is much simpler. We have our parent class that just has our simple rendering functions. And then our main page handler has actually gotten a lot shorter. All it does is it gets the items out of the URL and passes that into the shopping list template, which now has the structure of the HTML that we're actually generating. And this is a lot easier to think about than that madness we had before with string substitution and string concatenation and all of that. That was very difficult to read. And everything here works, you know, much more smoothly. Now, there is one little problem that I'd like to show you. Let's add some food here. Now we can just autocomplete our food because our shopping list is learning our tastes. What happens if I really want some pizza and I put our pizza in an H1? Okay, nothing. The HTML is not interpreted and the food is just added directly to our list. Or the raw HTML, in this case the H1, is displayed. Or is the HTML actually rendered, in which case our food appears very big in our list in this particular case? Why don't you go ahead and try yourself and see what happens?